Most people in life are looking at how do I make a life worth living and retirement having. Even the President of the United States has to follow the rules and the laws of the land. The two reasons he has to do this are pretty simple at hand. That first, by trade and by profession of his life, he's a lawyer. And the second is that in our lifetime, as American citizens, every single law of the land governs his life too. So when we're talking about the challenges and the disparagements and the conditions and the issues that affect the human race, he too has the same things he must face. What I mean is that in America there is a law for every industry, and in America there's always a law that governs you and me. And what that means is that your life is your life and someone else's life is their life, and we don't have the right to play into someone's life as a stranger and get away with putting them in danger. There are people that have opinions on all kinds of issues in the world. There are people that think that children of Down syndrome should be put somewhere else. But let me tell you, I find that offensive in my opinion and my experience of how they are loving representatives of the Lord in a very different way. But in America, what I can tell you about birth defects is that there's all kinds of them. And even when we look around the world, we can see really unique versions of them. There are men with tails, there are men with furry faces, there's all kinds of things from all kinds of places. But what I'm saying to you is that the laws of America govern your life. And if you don't know our International Human Rights Treaty and how it protects our human rights, our religious rights, our medical rights, our technology rights, as individuals in our country that signed that and actually initiated that treaty, you're a moron. And you can't be a president of any company without knowing that treaty. At the same time, we have the U.S. Constitution that governs our lives. And the U.S. Constitution says we have certain rights, certain freedoms, certain opportunities in life. We also have the amendments, which is what the U.S. government over the course of time decided to add to the Constitution. That's what amendment means. I'm adding something to make more things clear, more things secure. There's a few amendments that we could probably adapt or adopt or streamline. That's true. But the most important ones are 1 and 4, to me, in my opinion, on you and me. What I mean is that the First Amendment protects our right to freedom of faith. It also allows us associations in life, meaning who we can connect with and what we can do with them. It also gives our reporters in the news industry the rights to disseminate factual, intellectual, educational information. The Fourth Amendment is something that is personal to me and should be 100% personal, and I mean really personal to you. Because what that amendment does is protects our personhood, meaning our physical body, from harm from any other person, any other body. What that also does is allows us the security of our possessions and our property, meaning our land, our house, the things that we've been gifted, the things that we've earned, the things that we've purchased, from theft, which is the biggest issue with that. Our technology, too, would be covered by that. Our cell phones, our computers, and a lot of cybercrime today exist by stupid little shits who want to be lord in your life. The third part of that is the protection of our legal documentation, what I like to call paperwork for our life. And what that says is that your paperwork, your birth certificate, your life certificate, your financial records, your banking records, your legacy records, or your liability records are all yours. And those are the most simple ones to explain. Did I say medical records? But in truth, none of those records are public. And they shouldn't be online. We have companies in America that are taking our private relationships and putting them online. They don't have a right to do that, in truth. Those companies should be shut down and abolished by the president. Those companies that take our life records and our names and all that shit and put it online with our age and our address and our phone numbers don't have our permission to disseminate where we live and what we do. They don't have the right to assimilate and presume that just because I have the same mother and father as you that I want anything to do with you in life. And we have a lot of families with a lot of dysfunction. Even the president's family probably has some dysfunction. Even the couplehood of them probably has some discord. But what I'm saying is that every person under our nation has laws to follow for their own industry, their own careers, their own profession, and the service, which is the whole point of our land, to other people like you.